Hello, my friend. Welcome to Tube U channel. I'm Henry.
When you watch a time-lapse video that how a beautiful 3D model has been made, we always wonder that how professional and how difficult it to make. Today, I will tell you that using Cura slide software plugin with very cheap accessories, less than $5, we can do the same work as a professional. Stick around. Let's start. When we talk about time-lapse in a 3D model made by a 3D printer, usually, they mean layer lapse that takes photos when the layer changes. You must keep the printer bed in the same place and fix the camera steady. It is professional work and also not so cheap before. Now, with the help of the Cura slice plugin, we can do it quite easy. When we use Cura, there is an extensions menu. You can select the post-processing and modify G-code. At the pop-up menu, select Add a Script. You will find time-lapse. There is a default setting that moves the print head to the corner place and wait for a little for you shoot the photos when the layer changes. It is simple, but there are several issues we must fix. First, we must take a photo just at that time, so we need a trigger that helps us push the camera shoot button, and we also need a good camera to take the photos. From YouTube videos, you can find a lot of tutorials that tell you how to make a 3D printed accessory to fix the trigger. I think no better trigger than the original single pull double through SPDT switch that the 3D printer used itself. We maybe don't know exactly the model of SPDT switch of your printer using, but this cheap SPDT switch, which I bought from Amazon, is doing the exactly same job as my Anycubic printer. It is about $0.4 each. They are very stable and reliable. Here, we can see there are three pins in the switch. One is called Common, represented by C. Another is called NO, represented Normal Open. It means normally it is open. When you push the button, it will connect. The other is called NC, which represented Normal Close. It just does the opposite work as NO pin. We will use common and NO pins this time. Before soldering, it is better to use soldering paste to clean the pin and wire oxidized layer above the surface, if it exists. Then add tin first, since it will help to solder easier. You can fix the SPDT switch with some glue on board or use my 3D designed simple motor. It will help you fix the switch easier. You can fix them with an M5 screw if there is a hole exist in your printer head frame, or just fix them with both side adhesive tape. It is strong enough, since the SPDT switch is easy to trigger and stable. You can directly wire them to another Bluetooth remote control. It is also very cheap and popular to operate the smartphone with Safi function. You can find them in any Amazon shop for $5. I have got my remote controller as an iPhone tripod accessory. After pairing with your smartphone, you can control your smartphone camera with this remote controller. After opening the remote control case, you will find a small button. We can wire the SPD switch to this place parallel. It means that you can control the remote controller with the original button, or you can control the remote controller with SPDT switch.
After wiring them, you can connect them together.
In my case, I use four small neodymium magnets as the connector. When I use the time-lapse function, I connect them together. Otherwise, the remote controller still can be used as normal. Now the trigger switch is fixed. Let's find the correct position to trigger the signal. Since I fixed them on the printer head frame, they will always use the same Y and Z axis position with the printer head. We only need to find the X position. In any cubic printer touch panel of start menu, you can find the start icon. Press and choose status submenu. The printer will tell you the printer condition, where you can find X, Y, and Z axis position. Go back to the Start menu and select the Tools menu. Select Home, Home X. The printer will move the printer head to the X to 0 position. Back to the Uplabel menu and select Axis. On the following menu, press plus X 10 continuously. The printer head will move to the right side. Move the head close enough to the SPDT switch, but not touch it. Adjust the position with plus X plus 1. go back to the Start menu and select the Setup icon. Press the Status icon and check the X position number and write down XS, X Start. Go back and press X plus 1 to move the head to completely turn on the SPDT switch. Usually, you will add 4 or 5 mm. Go back and check the status, write the X position number, XT, X-Trig. These two numbers represent the standby position, XS, and the trigger position, XT. Now we know the parameters of how to trigger the SPD switch. If you use another 3D printer, please find these two parameters according to the instruction menu. Now let's start making our time-lapse video. Go back to Cura and open a STL model file. Click Extensions, Post-Processing, and Modify G-Code. In the time-lapse menu, the default setup will make the printer head go to the left side corner and wait 700 milliseconds for take a photo. We don't want to mount the SPD switch on the left side, since at first printer will initialize. Usually, they will go to the left side from the corner. We mount the SPD switch on the right side head frame and change the M240 which tells the printer to trigger the camera. We already know how to trigger the camera, so this is not necessary. We change it to G0 XT Y190, where my X trigger value is 215. It tells the printer to go to X 21.5 mm, Y 19 mm axis place. We leave other parameters as default, then slice the motor, export as G-code format and start printing. You will use the take photo function instead use take video in your camera. It will take photos when layer change. Let's go. I have found that when layer change, the printer head always go to the left back corner first, then go to X 215, Y 190 place and wait 700 milliseconds. Go to left side is not necessary. 700 milliseconds is too long. I got two folders once a time. Let's check the G-code file using Notepad. Search time. We found the time-lapse begin. G1 F9000 X0 Y190 test printer go linearly to X0 Y190 with a speed of 9000 mm per minute. High speed. We can change it to our standby position. In Cura, we change the time-lapse parameter again. Change the park print head X to XS, where my X start is 210. Also, change the pose length to 3000 milliseconds. Slice the motor again, export as G-code. If we check the G-code file, we can find the code has been changed, as we expected. Let's try again. This time everything looks good, except the motor has a string problem in my case. If you are lucky, everything is fine, then this tutorial is finished here. But I must do more to solve this problem. It means that I need more control to do time-lapse. Search the internet, we can find a good solution to do this. It is called a custom time-lapse plugin. Go to the homepage link below. You can download the script developed by the Mr. Simon Jomin. Unzip the file and copy the file to the Cura plugin folder. You can find the folder location with the help menu. Show configuration folder, scripts. Restart Cura again. This time in modify G-code pop-up menu, you can find custom time-lapse. Remove former time-lapse script. We will not use that again. Add custom time-lapse in your project. In the G-code for the first position input G0 XS Y190 F9000, where XS is 210 in my case. In the G-code for the second position input G0 XT Y190 F2000, where XT is 215 in my case. They tell the printer to go to X 210 Y190 at a faster speed, 9000 mm per minute. Go to X215 Y190 at low speed, 2000 mm per minute. It will help the camera take photo better. In the specify a return speed, check. I use 8000 mm per minute faster return. Pulse length is 3000 milliseconds. We don't need a long time waiting. Enable retraction is good for decreased spring.
It will re-roll back the filament a little when moving. I leave it default when I first try. Display current photo number option. You can choose what you like. Send the camera command is not necessary. Okay, let's try it. I have found that every time the printer head will go to zero position, then go back and print again when layer change. Others look like good, so we check the G-code file with notepad, search time, and find the time-lapse part. We can see some important change between custom and formal. It also levels up the printer head a little, Z-axis 1mm up. It will also decrease the string program. Then, we found the program sentence, G0F8000X8Y8. It tells the printer head to go to X8Y8, almost at the zero position. Copy it, go back to Cura. In Cura time-lapse script, we add another script. It is called
If you have seen the video here, please do me a favor. Subscribe to my channel and click the small bell, so you will not miss the update. TLBU channel is waiting for you.